girls and boys. This morning we meet up once again in the virtual space, worshipping our Lord as we look at Jesus' Transfiguration. And I know some of you, for some reasons, cannot come to church, but that does not stop us from worshipping. So let's join the entire congregation in worshipping this morning as we look at the Transfiguration of Christ. First, let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before your throne of grace this morning with hearts full of thanksgiving. We thank you, Lord, for your glory. We thank you, Lord, for your splendor. I pray, Lord, that as we learn about your glory in Christ this morning, we will be transformed in our hearts, and we will know you better, and we will live in your glorious splendor. We pray, Lord God Almighty, that you continue to protect and safeguard us, Lord. We commend our listeners unto you. We commend our teachers unto you. We commend our parents, our guardians, our friends, our loved ones, and everyone in our sphere of influence unto you, Lord. May you bless and direct them. I pray, Father God, that we will be taught about your word and will grow in your knowledge in Jesus' mighty name. So, girls and boys, today we're going to be looking the scripture in Luke chapter 9, verse 28 to 36. The word reads, about 8 days after Jesus said this, he took Peter, John, and James with him and went up onto a mountain to pray. As he was praying, the appearance of his face changed, and his clothes became as bright as a flash of lightning. Two men, Moses and Elijah, appeared in glorious splendor, talking with Jesus. They spoke about his departure, which was about to bring to fulfillment at Jerusalem. Peter and his companions were very sleepy, but when they became fully awake, they saw his glory and the two men standing with him. As the men were leaving Jesus, Peter said to him, "Master, it is good for us to be here. Let us put up three shelters, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not even know what he was saying. While he was speaking, a cloud appeared and covered them, and they were afraid as they entered the cloud. A voice came from the cloud saying, "This is my son, whom I have chosen. Listen to him." When the voice had spoken, they found that Jesus was alone. The disciples kept this to themselves and did not tell anyone at that time what they had seen. Here ends the Bible reading. So, like I said, the topic today is Jesus' Transfiguration. And in this scripture that we just read, we hear that while Jesus was praying, his body or his face began to change, and his clothes shone like lightning. This means that it was what he was doing that connected him to his glory in heaven, to his glory in his Father, and his identity was actually revealed. God transformed him and brought his glory upon him during this moment. The disciples were sleepy, the way it says, but when they woke up, they saw him in his splendor or in his glory, and alongside with him were two men. Let's briefly talk about these two men. The two men were Moses. As you know, Moses is one of the heroes of faith, the men whom God chose to liberate or redeem the Israelites from the land of Egypt. Moses spent some 40 days with God while he was being given the Ten Commandments in Mount Sinai. And when he came down from the mountain, he was shining in God's glory because he'd spent so much time in God's glory. And when the Israelites saw him, they ran away from him because of that glory. He had to put a veil on his face so that he could talk to his fellow Israelites. And this is because the presence of God was permeating through him and was revealed through his verse. And the second man who is appearing here is the prophet Elijah. We know that Elijah did not die like all the other people do when we finished our short lifespan we given on earth, but he was taken to heaven in a chariot of fire. And that means God transforms his faithful servants into glorious beings when they get to heaven, and even sends them on assignments on earth, as we can see now, Moses and Elijah in the glory of God have been sent to speak to God the Son in his splendor. And they are discussing a very important matter, the matter of our salvation, the matter of our redemption, our forgiveness of our sins. I know last week you learned about forgiveness as you were dwelling on the book of Genesis, looking at the character of Joseph. So Christ came on earth to fulfill a purpose, and that is redeeming us from our sinfulness, so that we can also partake in the glory of God. We can also have those glorious bodies that Moses and Elijah are having now. So this transfiguration we are talking about today is the transformation from this mere mortal body into a glorious body which is filled with the splendor and glory of God. We also read about the same transfiguration in the books of Matthew chapter 17 verse 2 and Mark chapter 9 verses 2 to 3. We also read about this splendor or the transformation in 2 Corinthians 3:18, which speaks about us, the followers of Christ, that and we all who will with unveiled faces contemplate the Lord's glory are being transformed into his image with ever increasing glory, which comes from the Lord who is the Spirit. We know that the Spirit of the Lord lives in us. The Holy Spirit is in our souls, and it is this Holy Spirit that keeps us connected to the vine, our Lord Jesus Christ, connected to God the Father. And it is through this Holy Spirit that we are transformed, we are glorified. So if we keep in the vine, we keep in the Holy Spirit, we keep in the glory of God, and we can hope for our transformed bodies or transformed lives. If we listen to the song carefully, it was saying the hidden glory of God revealed. So this is the hidden glory of God that was revealed through his glorious appearance. What lessons do we learn? Jesus is the glorious Son of God. His hidden glory is revealed to his chosen ones. You and I are his chosen ones. God transforms his faithful servants. Look at Moses and Elijah coming in the glory of God to speak to the glorious Jesus Christ. God sends his servants in his splendor to deliver his messages. Oh, even when you look at the Bible encounters of Israelites or Christians with God, you always see that there will be an angel who will be in the splendor of God. So God reveals himself through his splendor. Jesus was transfigured while praying. Praying or prayer brings the glory of God to earth. We also learn that Jesus saw the glory of disciples saw the glory of Christ and his comfort in the Spirit. The Holy Spirit is an enabler for us believers to witness God's glory. This week, boys and girls, I want you to go and answer some questions for me. Being princess of the kingdom, this should be easy. How was Jesus transformed? What was he doing when he began to transfigure? What are some of the visible changes the disciples witnessed? Who appeared alongside Jesus in splendor? What was discussed between Jesus and his glorious company? I hope you make time to read through the different verses that I shared with you as you interrogate these questions and get a deeper meaning of what this glorious appearance of Christ means for each and every one of us. Jesus was praying. This is in the summary of what we did today. The appearance of his face changed, and his clothes became as bright as a flash of lightning. That is in verse 29. And verse 30 goes on to say, two men, Moses and Elijah, appeared in glorious splendor, talking of Jesus. They spoke about his departure, which he was about to bring to fulfillment at Jerusalem. That is in verse 31. And we are left with a promise in the word. If you read in the book of Philippians 3, verse 21, it says, who by his power, by the power that enables him to bring everything under his control, will transform our lowly bodies so that they will be like his glorious body. So as we look forward to these glorious bodies, for his second coming, for our eternity in heaven, in our glorious appearances, may we continue to stay in the vine and rejoice in the glory of Christ. Thank you, princes and princesses of the kingdom. Have a blessing filled week. Till we meet again, say bye from us.